Friends, our next topic is narrow band noise. Narrow band noise is same as low pass filtered white noise. Here, at the receiver side, the ideal low pass filter is considered as a narrow band filter with input as Gaussian white noise denoted by W function T. Also, we know that the power spectral density of Gaussian white noise is N0 by 2, that is denoted by capital S function F, that is shown in figure. After filtering, the Gaussian white noise WT get converted into filtered noise or narrow band noise. Typically, WT is called as front end receiver noise, and the power spectral density of narrow band noise having a value of N0 by 2, but it is limited between minus B to plus B. That is same as the bandwidth of narrow band filter. As shown in figure, the power spectral density of filtered noise is centered at origin, but practically in communication system, using modulation process, the spectrum of narrowband noise is shifted and centered at the midband frequency of plus minus fc. Here, the dotted line represents an ideal curve. Now we note a point. The sample function of the narrowband noise, that is nt, is approximately similar to the sine wave and varies slowly in amplitude and phase. This is just like an envelope as shown in figure. Now, as NT is narrowband noise, which is random in nature, so we call it as narrowband process denoted by capital N function T. And this can be represented mathematically in terms of in-phase and quadrature components. Also, as the narrowband noise is centered at plus minus FC with the bandwidth of twice of B, we call narrowband noise process also having a bandwidth of 2B and centered at positive frequency FC. Mathematically, narrowband process, that is capital N function T, having two components, that is in phase component Ni and quadrature component Nq, and both are called low pass random process. So random process capital N function T equals to Ni cos 2pi fct minus Nq sin 2pi fct. Next we discuss the generation of narrowband noise as shown in figure. Here, the in-phase component Ni is first multiplied by cos 2pi fct and quadrature phase component Nq is multiplied by sin 2pi fct and get added using summer taking negative sign with quadrature component. Next, at the receiver side, there is a process of detection or extraction of in-phase and quadrature component of narrowband process. Here, the narrowband noise process, that is capital N function T, is individually multiplied by the locally generated carrier, that is 2 cos 2 pi fct in case of in-phase component and 2 sin 2 pi fct in case of quadrature component with negative sign. Now, after passing through low pass filter, we get in-phase component and quadrature component of narrowband process. Now, first consider upper in-phase path. The input of the low pass filter is Nt into 2 cos 2 pi fct. In place of narrowband process Nt, we can write Nit cos 2 pi fct minus Nqt sin 2 pi fct. Now, after opening the bracket, we get Ni into 2 cos square 2 pi fct minus Nq into 2 sin 2 pi fct cos 2 pi fct. Now, using formula, in the first term, we can write 1 plus cos 4 pi fct and in the second term, we can write sin 4 pi fct. So, the input of the low pass filter having three terms. First one is in phase component and the other two are the high frequency component which can be removed using low pass filter. So at the output of the low pass filter 1, we get only in phase component called low pass random process. Similarly, for lower quadrature path, input of second low pass filter is nt into minus 2 sine 2 pi fct, and after putting nt in terms of in phase and quadrature component, and after rearrangement, we get minus ni sine 4 pi fct minus nq cos 4 pi fct plus nq function t. So, at the output of low pass filter, the high frequency components are removed. While it passes only the quadrature low pass random process denoted by nq function t. Next, we talk about properties of in phase and quadrature component of narrow band noise process denoted by capital N. Here, the first property is, if the narrow band noise process is Gaussian, then the in phase and quadrature component are also Gaussian. Second property is, if narrow band noise process is stationary, then also in phase and quadrature component of corresponding narrow band noise is strictly stationary. And the third property is, when the mean of in phase and quadrature component of narrow band noise process is equals to zero, then their power spectral density are identical. That is, capital S Ni is equals to capital S Nq. So the power spectral density of in phase and quadrature component show a relationship with respect to power spectral density of narrow band noise process, which is equals to S function F minus Fc plus S function F plus Fc for F greater or equals to minus B and less than or equals to plus B and zero otherwise. Now, to explain this relationship more clearly, we consider a band limited narrow band filter of bandwidth capital B. Its input is Gaussian white noise with power spectral density is SW function F and the output as narrow band noise of power spectral density SN function F. Practically, the narrow band noise spectrum is centered at the mid band frequency of plus minus Fc as shown in figure. Now the area under this curve is obtained using integration, that is integration of S and F dF, taking limit minus infinity to infinity, and it is equals to twice of N naught B. Since area of positive portion is N naught by 2 into 2B, that is N naught into B, so the total area under the curve is twice of N naught B. Now, according to our relation of power spectral density, Sn function F minus Fc is obtained by shifting spectrum towards right by Fc. So the left portion of Sn function F, that is at minus Fc, moves to the origin, and right portion of Sn F, which is at plus Fc, moves to twice of Fc. Similarly for Sn F plus Fc, the spectrum SNF is shifted towards left by Fc, that is as shown in figure. Now the narrow band filter act as a low pass filter. So removing the portion of higher component, that is twice of Fc, and after adding, we get a spectrum at origin with value of N naught between minus B to plus B. This power spectral density is similar to the power spectral density of in phase and quadrature component. Now we can compare the area under the curve of narrowband noise and in phase component. As we know that the narrowband noise having the area of twice of N naught B, and the power spectral density of in phase component, that is shown in figure, also having a bandwidth of 2B, so the area under this curve is also twice of N naught B. So it concluded that when the mean of in phase and quadrature component of narrow band process is equals to zero, then their power spectral density are identical, which gives the relationship between in phase and quadrature component with respect to power spectral density of narrow band noise process.